Hey guys, Bradley tuning in, coming out with another video. And if you didn't already know, the majority of condos in Toronto are not allowed to have Airbnb. In fact, there's only a small handful that do. And today I want to share with you exactly what that list is and where I found it and give a little bit more insight on how you can run an Airbnb legally in the city of Toronto. Before I get started, my name is Bradley. I do videos like this all the time to keep you up to date on the latest tips and tricks here in the GTA real estate market. Be sure you slam that subscribe button and we're gonna continue to put out fantastic content. In order to run an Airbnb legally in Toronto, two things need to happen. Number one, the municipality needs to allow it. And if they do not, then it's off limits. And in Toronto, it's in an interesting time, which I'll cover in a moment. But also, if you live in a condo, the condo board makes like a government where they need to allow you to also do it. So both things need to exist. Just like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Healthy and fattening. Yeah, no. That's dumb. Before we get into which condos are allowing you to currently have an Airbnb, I want to cover what the city of Toronto is doing, what the municipal level allows for as far as Airbnb goes. The city considers a short-term rental anything under 28 days, and you're currently allowed to rent up to 3 bedrooms on a short-term basis or your entire house. If you're looking to do a basement or an in-law suite, the main thing here is it needs to be your primary residence. You're also not allowed to rent it for more than 180 days of the year. They want to maintain the housing and that side of it, but you also need to register for $50 a year with the city so they know about it. And there's this tax of 4% that will come out called the municipal accommodations tax. So if you want to run an Airbnb, it's going to cost you a little bit of money, and this is what the city requires if you want to do it. The city approved the regulations for short-term rentals in late 2017, early 2018, and there was actually hearings in August of 2019, but no decision has yet been made. And in the meantime, they are not being enforced, these rules that we just covered. Now that we understand what the municipality is doing, remember, point number two is we need to make sure that the condo is allowing short-term rentals. Now, I found the perfect website. It's a fellow agent of mine here in the GTA. His name is Pierre. Not gonna try his last name, but I'm gonna leave the link down below if you wanna check out that full website. I actually contacted him because I'm like, dude, I have to be able to use this website. It's awesome and my viewers are gonna love it. It's great content and I'm not seeing it in many other places online. So I contacted him and I have not heard a word. Dead silence. So I think that kind of makes me a superhero.
Shameless promotion of another realtor man.
And he called me dumb. There's some great information on this website, but I want to share with you on this video which condos he's included as allowing Airbnb. Here's the list. Rev Condos, Aquarius Water Park City, Neptune 1 and 2, Ice 1 and 2, Local at Fort York, Quartz Condos, Spectra Condos, Maple Leaf Condos, Studio on Richmond, Quest Condos, Water Club Condos, The Verve Condos, Harbor Views Estates 2, and Parade 1 and 2. There you have it. That is the full list of condos allowing short-term rentals in Toronto, which is key if you want to do things in a legal way. If you're interested in any of those buildings, feel free to shoot me a message, and we're going to continue to put out fantastic content. Slam that subscribe button. I'll see you next time. Take care and keep it real.